I hope you all are fine and safe at home. I welcome you to Nagesh Karasgi Orchid School Channel. I am Miss Parvati Chaugule, your first grade English teacher. Students, what we were learning? Yes, we were learning grammar, isn't it? So, today we will learn our new lesson of grammar textbook, that is verb, okay? You should be ready with your pencil, eraser and grammar textbook. So here we go. Verbs. What is the name of our lesson? Verbs 1. V-E-R-B-S. Verbs 1. So before going to start this, here is one small get set. That is what we have to do. We have to see the picture and we have to tell what are the things going in this picture. See here, what are the people and the animals doing in this picture? That we have to tell, okay? Talk about it. We have to talk about the things, animals and people doing in this picture. So look at in your textbook and see what the animals and the people in this picture are doing. One is done for us. See here, a little boy is sitting on his dad's shoulders. What is the first sentence? A little boy is sitting on his dad's shoulders. Here we see in the picture, isn't it? See, now the next sentence, what we can make from this picture? Yes, see here, a girl is giving food to the dog, isn't it? She is giving food to the dog in this picture, isn't it? Now, the next what we can see in this picture is a small baby drinking milk with the bottle, isn't it? A small baby drinking milk with the bottle. Then what we can see in this picture? See here are the two animals. One is cat and one is rat. Rat is running and this cat is also running behind the rat, isn't it? And what we can see more in this picture, children? Yes, we can see a girl is kissing to her mom, isn't it? A girl is kissing to her mom. So like this, we have seen what the animals and the people are doing in this picture, isn't it? So like this, we have seen a get set, that is what are the people and animals doing in the picture. So now what we will do? We will read. So we will go for let us read. See here, read the story about Neha's birthday. What we have to do? We have to read the story of Neha's birthday. Pay attention to the words in italics. And we have to pay attention to the words in the italic, okay? We have to pay attention to the words in the italics. See here, we will read the story about Neha's birthday. Neha likes her birthday. Here, likes word is in italics. Neha likes her birthday. Now the next one, her friends are standing around her. And what is the next words in the italic? Her friends are standing around her. Here are and standing are in italics. Her friends are standing around her. Next, she is blowing the candle. What she is doing? Yes, she is blowing the candle. So here, she is blowing The candle here is blowing is a, yes, is blowing is a word in italic. Now the next one. Her friends are eating the cake. And what the friends are doing? Her friends are eating the cake. Here are eating is in italic, isn't it? Are eating is in italic. Next, the kids are playing with balloons. And what the kids are doing? Yes, the kids are playing with balloons. Here, are playing is in italics, isn't it? Yes, the kids are playing with balloons. Now the next one, the kids are dancing. Here, are dancing is in italics, isn't it? Are dancing is in italics. Now once again we will read the story and we will pay attention, we should pay attention to the words in the italics so that we can get to know what that words denote or what that words say. See here, Neha likes her birthday. Her friends are standing around her. She is blowing the candle. Her friends are eating the cake. The kids are playing with the balloons. The kids are dancing. And the kids are dancing. So like this, likes, are standing, is blowing, are eating, are playing, are dancing, these words are in italics. So these words are in italics, isn't it? These words are in italics. Like, are standing, is blowing, are eating, are playing, are dancing. These were the words in the italics. Now students, we will listen to, we will see an video, we will see a video, okay. Now you should pay attention to the video, what we are going to see in this.
Verbs. Hi students, let us learn about verbs today. Read these sentences and notice the words in blue. Neha likes her birthday. Her friends are standing around her. She is blowing the candle. Her friends are eating the cake. The kids are playing with balloons. The kids are dancing. The words in blue describe actions. Action words are called verbs. Some verbs are single words. Examples: cleans, eats, sleeps, reads, sings. Some verbs are two words. Examples: is cleaning, are eating, are sleeping, and reading, is singing. Action words usually come after nouns.
What are these? These are the verbs. Once again, we will play the video.
Verbs. Hi students, let us learn about verbs today. Read these sentences and notice the words in blue. Neha likes her birthday.
See here children, what we have to pay? We have to pay attention to the words in the blue. So here, Neha likes her birthday. Here likes is in blue. So we should pay more attention to the words in the blue. See now the next one.
Her friends are standing around her. She is blowing the candle. Her friends are eating the cake. The kids are playing with balloons. The kids are dancing. The words in blue describe actions. Action words are called verbs. Some verbs are single words. Examples: cleans, eats, sleeps, reads, sings.
See now. The words in blue describe action. The words which were in the blue in this, they were describing actions, isn't it? They were describing actions, means what the people were doing means action. Theek hai? What all the things we do, or we do something like we read, we write, we play, that all are the actions. Here the words in the blue describe actions. Now what are the action? Action words are called verbs. What are the action words called? Action words are called as verbs. The action words are called verbs. We must keep in mind that what the action words are called as? Yes, the action words are called as verbs. Some verbs are single words and some verbs are single words, isn't it? Some verbs are single words. Examples: cleans, eats, sleeps, reads, sings. So these are the single words. These are the examples of single words, means these are cleans, eats, sleeps, reads, sings are the examples of single verb words. Single verb words. Okay. Now what? Once again, action words are called as verbs. What are the action words? Playing, reading, writing. These all are the action words and they are called as verbs. What they are called as? Verbs. So the action words are called as verbs, isn't it? The action words are called as verbs. Now see,
some verbs are two words. Examples: is cleaning, or eating, or sleeping, and reading, is singing.
See here, some verbs are two words. We have seen the words single verbs. Okay. In earlier slide, we have seen single verb words. Now, some verbs are two words. Some verbs are two words. Now, see examples: is cleaning, are eating, are sleeping, are reading, is singing. So these are the, what are these? These are the two words verb. These are the two words verb. Now see, action words usually come after nouns. And what? The action words are called as? What are the action words called as? Action words are called as verbs. And action words usually comes after nouns. We should keep in mind that action words usually comes after noun. See here,
action words usually come after nouns.
Okay, action words usually come after nouns. So here we have seen the video. Now see, all the verbs in italics describe actions. Action words are called as verbs. Action, I have told you, what are the action words called as? Yes, the action words are called as verbs. Some verbs are single words and some verbs are single words. For example, likes, eats, sings. Okay. Some verbs are two words and some verbs are two words. Some verbs are single word and some verbs are two words. Two words verb, action example see, are eating, are playing, isn't it? Are eating, are playing. Now, action words usually come after nouns. And we should keep in mind that action words usually comes after nouns. Okay, action words usually comes after nouns. Action words usually comes after noun. Now children, see here what we have to do. Now we will practice. What we will do? Now we will practice. What we have to practice children? Yes, now we will practice. Let us practice. Color the verbs red. Now, here are some words given to us, isn't it? Here are some words given to us. Now we have to do, we have to color the words which are noun. Means first we have to identify what are verbs, isn't it? Yes, not noun. We have to first identify the words which are verb and then we have to color them red. See here, color the verbs red. One is done for us, talk. We are talking. So this word talk is describing some action, isn't it? So it is a verb. Action words are called as verbs. Fast is action? No, fast is not the action. Fast is not the action. Now see, the next one is jump. Jump means, yes, up and down when we do, it is jumping. Is it jumping an action word? Yes, jumping is a action word, isn't it? So now we will color it with red. You have to do in your textbook, children, okay? You have to do in your textbook. So here jump, we have to color it with red. Now start. Start is a verb? No. But see now the next word, walk. When we walk, when we go from one place to another place, we walk usually. See, when we have to cover a small distance, when we want to go from bedroom to the kitchen, we will walk, isn't it? So walk is a action. We do some actions. So it is a verb, isn't it? It is a verb. So color it with red. So color it with red. Now the next one, finger. These are the fingers. Is it a verb? No. Speak. Speak is a verb? Yes, we speak. Speak is a verb. It is a action. Action words are called as verbs. So we have to color it with red. Next is draw. We draw painting. We do painting. We draw elephant, isn't it? We draw many things which we see or which we like. So draw is a action. We do usually action and that action words are called as verbs, isn't it? Draw. Small. Small in the sense, when we see, when we say small, yes, in the sense of height. So is it a verb? No. Rub. Rub means when we rub the palms, anything. When two surfaces comes in contact and rub each other, that is rubbing. So now here, rub is an action, isn't it? We erase or we rub eraser on a paper, isn't it? So rub is a action. It is a action word. So it is a verb. Okay, now take down in your textbook, children. Do it fast. With red you have to do. You have to use red color, isn't it? Which color you have to use? You have to use red color. You have to use red color. Okay. Now, we will move to the next question from Let Us Practice. See here what we have to do. Choose the right verbs from the box and complete the sentences. We have to choose the right verbs from the box. This is a box given to us. We have to choose the right word and complete these sentences. One is done for us. We write with a pencil, isn't it? We write with a pencil. Now, we dash with a knife. What we do, children, with a knife? Yes, we cut with a knife. C-U-T, cut. We cut with a knife. What we do? We cut with a knife, isn't it? Now the next. We dash with our teeth. What we do with our teeth? What we do with our teeth? Bite. B-I-T-E. Bite. B-I-T-E. Bite. We bite with our teeth. We bite with our teeth. Next. We dash a kite. What we do? What we do? Do we speak? No. Yes. We fly. F-L-Y. Fly. We fly a kite. What we do? We fly a kite. Now the next. We dash on the phone. What we do on the phone? Yes. We speak on the phone. S-P-E-A-K. Speak. We speak on the phone. We speak on the phone. Isn't it? We speak on the phone. Now see, once again, we write with a pencil. We cut with a knife. We bite with our teeth. We fly a kite. We speak on the phone. And we speak on the phone. Now, do it in your textbook. Take down. Okay, shall we move for the next question? Shall we move for the next question? Once again, see, we write with a pencil. Take down in your textbook, these all the blanks, okay? We cut with a knife. We bite with our teeth. We fly a kite. We speak on the phone. We speak on the phone. So now I'm going to rub and now we will see the next question. What we will do? We will see the next question of Let Us Practice. Let us practice the next question, that is C1. Match the pictures with the verbs. What we have to do? We have to match the pictures. These are the pictures. Okay, these are the pictures. And we have to match the pictures with the verbs. These are the verbs in written. Now we have to match with the verbs. See here, one is done for us. Jumping is here. What this boy is doing? He is jumping. This is jumping. Now, the next one, falling. Where you can see falling in the picture? Yes, this boy is falling, isn't it? So, we have to match this falling. Isn't it? Falling. Next, walking. What the boy, what? Where is the boy walking, children? Do we see in the picture? Yes, here it is. So, it will come like this, walking. And the last, and the next one is running. This boy is running. So, this is the action of running. See once again, falling, walking, running. Okay, falling, walking, running. Next, lifting. lifting, uthana, jisko bolte. Lifting means uthana. Where you can see lifting in the picture? Is he lifting? No, this is a picture of lifting. So here we match. Now the next one is eating. This boy is doing the action of eating, isn't it? This boy is doing the action of eating. Drinking. This boy is doing the action of drinking. And last one is painting. This boy is doing the action of painting. Okay. Once again, see. Jumping, falling, walking, running, eating, lifting, painting and drinking. Okay. Now do in your textbook, take down in your textbook children, do it fast. Do it fast. Have you completed? Match the pictures with the verbs. Jumping, falling, walking, running, lifting, eating, drinking, painting. Okay. These are the words and the verbs we have to match. So now we will move towards the next question of let us practice. Now what we have to do in this question? Complete the sentences with the correct verbs. We have to complete these sentences with the correct verb. What we have to do? We have to complete the sentences with the correct verbs, isn't it? See now, one is done for us. We eat food when we are hungry. What we do when we are hungry? Yes, we eat food when we are hungry. Next, we dash water when we are thirsty. And when we are thirsty, what we do, children? What we do? Yes, we drink, isn't it? We drink water when we are thirsty. So here it will come D-R-I-N-K, drink. We drink water when we are thirsty. We drink water when we are thirsty, isn't it? See, we eat food when we are hungry. What we do when we are hungry? We eat food. We drink water when we are thirsty. And when we are thirsty, what we do? We drink water. Next, we dash games when we want some fun. And when we want some fun, what we do? Yes, we play. P-L-A-Y, play. We play games when we want some fun, isn't it? We play games when we want some fun. Next, we dash videos for pleasure. What we do? Videos for pleasure? Yes, we watch. So here it comes watch. W-A-T-C-H. We watch videos for pleasure. What we do? We watch videos for pleasure. Next, we dash when we are tired. When we are tired, then what we do? Yes, we take sleep. So we sleep, S-L-E-E-P, sleep. We sleep when we are tired, isn't it? We sleep when we are tired. Once again, see, we eat food when we are hungry. We drink water when we are thirsty. We play games when we want some fun. We watch videos for pleasure. We sleep when we are tired. Okay, so these are eat, drink, play, watch, sleep. These all are the actions. What are these? These are the actions. Now take down in your textbook. And the action words are called as verbs. and the action words are called as verbs. So, students, in today's class we have seen what are the action words called. What are the action words called? Yes, the action words are called as verbs. So, the further part of this lesson we will continue in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye.